They are incredibly stoic animals. There is no other animal I have ever met that doesn't show outward signs of pain the way the moon bears do. Pixie would have had her gallbladder removed by one of our vets here when she first arrived. It was likely diseased and painful for her, so that was removed. We always check around that area to make sure that there's no signs of inflammation or pain in that area now. She came in for her routine health check. When the bears are under anesthetic, they are unable to regulate their own body temperature. We pop mittens on their feet and we surround them with warm water bottles. A lot of our supporters really love to knit these mittens for the bears. I actually live on site. I can open my window and I can see the bears wandering around and foraging. We live and work with these bears 24/7. They become a part of your family.
Hey, go la, go la.
我们大部分时间就在观察熊里吃活动，喂药来，我们就是上下午两次药。有的熊那个药味道出来，它不喜欢吃，这是棉花糖，包进去要好一点。我来这中心已经差不多都13年多了，看到熊那个抽胆汁啊，那个新闻，所产生一种同情，所以说我就来这边应聘。 比如说摇头、反复走动，这些行为都属于刻板反复行为，可能是在那个养熊场那个待时间长，就产生出来后遗症。这个后遗症它是永远改不了的。早上啊，我们上班之前不是装饰草场嘛，就是按照熊那个生活习惯，比如说不同的一个位置放，让它们寻找、攀爬，因为好多熊的骨骼也不是很好，就让它自己站立站立一下。
每一头叫狮熊，我们觉得都心里特别不舒服。我们在一起，天天在一起，也产生感情了。到了，这里就是我们那个阿的那个黑熊相机，又拍到了黑熊。 这个是发的牛肉和鸭肉的诱饵，我们这个是以杀鸡血来拍这个黑熊的个体识别，所以上面这它是抓不着的，所以它要站起来就拍到它那个疤，每个疤都不一样的，跟那个人的指纹一样。在保护区已经干了11年的驯服员了，具体工作的话，打熊猫、挖根节菜啊，黑熊个体识别啊。 还有识别这个植物的工作都在做，因为我是土生土长的人，我叔叔都是干这个驯服工作，相当于是我是学了带来那种驯服员以后还是继续做，娃儿也喜欢这个工作的话，一直这样子传下去。